Okay guys, welcome to the class today. I will start quickly with the turban. That's the base itself, the turban itself. And then I'll come back to, this is the top. This is the top part. And for this top part, I actually used 60 inches length. So because I used 1 yard of material for this project, if I cut out 60 inches and considering the part that is stretchy, I will not be able to get the cap out. So for that reason, I had to cut out the cap first. Then I came back to join material so that I can get up to 60 for the length I need to use. So quickly, I'll start with the turban base itself. So the measurement I used for the turban, the width, the length. Usually my turban back is 14, but because I needed to fold the part you see me cutting out now, I added 5. So which means I used 5 to create the band for the turban, and then the remaining 14, I'll fix it behind. So sometimes I make my band this way. I'll just fold the material, sew the band, trim it out, and then later I'll fix it back on it. Yes, so the scissors I use is the zigzag scissors, just to help me design the tip, since I'm not going to weave it. So for that reason, I use the zigzag scissors. So right now I just pin it through, and then I'll take it back to my machine, and then I'll sew it. So the length of the base, I said this turban, the previous one I cut was about 25 by 19. You know, the round head is 22, so usually I give space. I can work with 24, which when I fold it, I'll get 12, you understand? So usually I give space. So right now that I'm done attaching that, I'll take the actual measurement I want now. So for the head, usually I work with 10 or 10 and a half. Because it's a stretchy material, of course, you don't need to work with 11. 11 will be the complete length for your round head, so you don't need 11. So you work with 10 to enable the turban sit on the head. Is that okay? So for me now, I am taking the measurement I will be needing, and I worked with 10 and a half, just like you can see, 10 and a half. The reason I do this is most times when I sew the turban without really taking the head measurement of my client, I make it 10 and a half. If it's too big, it's very easy to reduce, to reduce it, you understand? Because when it becomes too small, you cannot add to it since you are going to trim it anyway. Okay, so right now, my turban, you can see the part I drew there now. This is how it will go when I am going to sew it. But before I'll go to my machine, I'll quickly use the zigzag scissors again to cut out the excess part. Yes, I'll just cut out the excess part. So you see the sharp part there where I had to like star. That part, if you are confused on how you will curve that part, just use your measuring tape from that angle, take away 2 inches. When you mark the 2 inches, then you connect your line to the 2 inches, it will be perfect. So it's very okay. So this is the turban itself. I'll take it to my machine, run it, I'll get back to you. All right, I am done with that. Yeah, so the cap is ready, but one thing I'm going to do is I'll need to pull it together. And for me to do that, I'll be using a thread, a needle and thread. One thing I normally do with my thread is I like to make it so thick. So when I fold my thread, before I'll thread it, I fold it into 4. So by the time I thread it, I'll be getting 8. You can see how thick it will be. So it's very difficult for such a amount of thread to like give way. So I work with 8. My thread is usually very thick, so that whatever I do with it, I'll be very sure that yeah, it's firm. Okay, so right now for me to pull this turban together, I'm going to start after the band of the turban. So you are not supposed to include the band to it, you understand? So whenever you are going to pull your fabric or your turban together, ensure to leave the band out of it. So I have left the band out of it. So since I'm pulling now, you see that the band is not inclusive. And the way I am pulling, or the method I'm using, is that I'm using the loose stitches, you understand, just working with my needle and thread and just putting it in, out, or back, front, with some regular distance. Your distance can be 1/2 inch, can be 1 inch, but just make sure that it's not too far apart. So after pulling it together, I will be done with the turban, that is the base itself. Then I'll come up to talk on how to prepare the top. Is that okay? Okay, it's time to talk about the design. This is for the top, and like I said before, the measurement for this, the length is 60 and the width is 7, that is 7 after fold, but 14 before fold. So very simple. I'm just going to use the same needle and thread and just do loose stitches, and then I'll pull it together. Once I make the loose stitches, I'll pull it together. I do hope that you notice the fact that I did not close this end. The reason I did not close it is, it's not really like a special reason though, but I find out that when I close the edge before doing the loose stitches, it becomes so thick. It becomes like something too thick for me. So most times I just sew the edges and then I leave that edge open so that it will not be too thick for me. So right now I am done pulling it together, and this is what I will get. This is what I'll get. All right, now very important thing you should take note of is that the thread I used in pulling it, I do not stick it, as in I'm not going to lock the end after doing what I did. This is so that I can have space. I can still like free it when I want to free. That is, I can adjust it. Yes, that's the right one. So that I can adjust it. So for that reason, I did not lock the thread. So this is not the final size I'm going to use. As I begin to style it, I'll be able to pull it. I'll be able to free it, move it when I want to move, release when I want to release, tighten it when I want to tighten. You understand? So for that reason, you are not supposed to like end your sewing by knotting, that is by tying it. So I do not tie. Until I am done with styling the turban, I don't tie it. Until I am done, I don't tie it. That's just something. If I need to do any other work that I need thread, I thread a separate needle and use it separately. While the one I use for my, you can see that I'm using two separate needles there now. So that the one I use to do the loose stitches for the pulling will just still be there until I am done with the style completely. I do hope you understand it. Okay, I've showed you earlier how I pull down the edges and make it round. Yeah, so if you don't like it standing this way, you can just do the same loose stitches on it and pull it together. So with that, it will no longer stand and start showing the edge. It will just be like complete round, you understand? To just form that complete round rows that you are looking for. Okay, I am done with this. So this is just how I style it. I just twist it depending on how many twists I actually bargain for. I can twist up to 2-3 times depending on what I want. But for this particular style, I just used 2. You know, the first turn and then the second one going on top of it. And then finally, I just like bring down the final edge to make it look like a big rose. Okay, so let me take you back to the beginning. I just want to show you something. I hope it's here, but I just hope it is here. I wanted to show you something I did with the inside. So let me just hope it's here. Okay. Okay, this is what I wanted to show you. What I normally do to the beginning before I turn the other part. So what I do is I start by taking the size I want under. So how wide I want it to be. After that, I'll use my needle and thread to close the edges together. This helps to like protect it from breaking down. As in, I don't know the best way to explain it, but when you do this one, it's preserve that your roses. You understand? And there will be no probability of it just giving way while your client is using it. So as much as possible, I just pick my size and then I lock it up with thread. You understand? Bring the two edges. I just kiss the edges together with my needle and thread. Yeah. Then after this process, I'll go ahead to turn the rose, you understand? Because what I'm doing now is actually a big rose. Yeah, so I'll just go ahead to turn the rose. Yeah, I do hope you enjoy the class, because this is all I'll have for you today. This is all I have for you today. I want to say thank you for stopping by. And for those that are yet to subscribe to the channel, please do so. I don't want to say, what are you waiting for? But I want to say, please do so. My intention is that everyone stopping by this place, everyone stopping here that are serious, you don't really need to go anywhere else to learn before you can become a professional on your own. You understand? The same way I train people in my store, or in my business place, is the same way I train online. So that's just the truth. Sometimes I even feel like I explain more online than those persons learning from me directly, because When I'm learning directly, I just expect you to watch me. But when I'm doing the online, I will try as much as possible to give the explanations that I can. So thank you once again for being here. I'm done with this tutorial. You can understand the rest part without me explaining. Bye. Again, don't forget to watch to the end because everything is still inside. Watch to the end.